Hello, Paul here. I'm sitting with Zach, who's a program manager on the Windows Intune team. And today we're going to talk a little bit about the Windows Intune Center. Now, that's the client piece that gets installed on all the managed PCs, and it allows your users to do certain types of activities. First of all, it allows them to go and look at their Windows updates and see what updates are pending, what updates have been installed, and so forth. And I should point out that those updates are the ones that the Windows Intune administrator has approved. So it's not really all updates, it's just the updates that the administrator has approved and permitted to go onto the PCs that they're managing. The third option is the Microsoft Easy Assist. And we're going to talk about that in another video. It's where a user can go to request a remote assistance session from your system administrator. Today, what we want to talk about is the Windows Intune malware protection dialog, and Zach's going to talk a little bit more about that. So, Zach, why don't you walk us through the tabs and tell us what we're looking at?
So, in this first tab right here, this is basically just a status tab and allows you to begin scans, quick scans and full machine scans, and then a custom scan, which will let you specify which folders you want to scan on. Update tab is pretty simple. This will just update your malware definitions. So if you think that your definitions might be a few days old and there's some new virus out, you want to make sure it gets catched, it'll be in there. History tab, this is exactly what you should see in the admin console for Windows Intune. This is just the pieces of malware that happen to be on that machine. Right now, we're all safe. There's nothing detected. The settings tab is where there's really a lot more information. And this is where if you were an end user, you could say, don't run a scheduled scan, for instance, things like this.
Now, I'm going to stop you right there, Zach. Are you saying that the end users have the ability to disable their malware?
So, out of the box, this is what the end user will see. But as soon as an admin creates a policy around agent settings, these things become grayed out and the user no longer is able to change them. So, for instance, real-time protection is a big one for this. You never really want to turn real-time protection off. This is on-access file scanning. So right now, my end user can turn it off. This is bad. So in order to gray this out and make a user unable to turn it off, we go to the admin console. We say create a new policy. Go to agent settings. And if we go down to malware protection, we see all of these right here. So we say yes. We want to enable it. I guess we should probably name the policy. So we go down, we say it's enabled, that's great. We save the policy, and we deploy it.
I see. So the first thing that anybody should do with Windows Intune is really start setting up these policies.
Absolutely.
Terrific. And that's going to help our Windows Intune administrators get up and running very quickly and make sure their PCs are safe and secure. Thanks very much, Zach, for showing us that.
No problem. Thanks, Paul.
So thanks for listening, and we hope you enjoy using Windows Intune. See you next time.